how are you going to include the neighborhood in your artistic adventures? We don't want a neighborhood full of Porsches and Ferraris. What we want, more importantly, is like some social identity. And that's where the Penn Avenue gets its strength, is that most and all of art galleries have a social component, whether it be teaching math and science, or our Learn to Earn program, or the STEM programs, or children, or adults. These programs for the neighborhood are always brought to us for them for free. And we do it all together because we all want to see the neighborhood stay the way it is. We don't want to be turned over. We want the same families to own the same houses. And we want to include them. And we have the opportunity to do that because we're basically starting with a blank slate. The only thing left was a few service businesses. The neighborhood is basically service businesses. You know, your sweeper, fixer, your shoe repair, those type of repairs, nuts and bolts types businesses. So the architecture wasn't very appealing, which made like Southside very appealing. The architecture was very Victorian and beautiful. Ours was very plain and brutalist, if you know that architecture. Those type of things were happening because how it was rebuilt in the 50s. So we were taking away some urban renewal ideas that didn't work out so well, and we started creating opportunity for artists. There was grants involved. We had events happening on the streets because sometimes it was hard to just get people into the buildings. So we would have events on the sidewalks. We would close off the streets. And that way the art was out there and people can participate. Just like we have a coloring table. Everywhere we go, we have a coloring table for anybody just to engage in artwork. And we find that very important. And that's like our life mission.
Other questions? Anyone? Yeah, we're here.
I'm not going to ask a question, but I'm going to say this as a longtime resident of the East End. I've seen that transition happen. I've seen it from, I'm not going to give away my age, but I'm going to say the 80s and the 90s when the East End was relatively segregated by urban renewal. And you know, that was really something that broke the barrier for artists to be able to express themselves. That barrier, and a lot of those infrastructures are torn down, and I know there was a lot of controversy about relocating those residents and regentrification. But what's happened to Penn Avenue, and trust me, you know, I was there at 16, 18 years old, is amazing with the development of the quarter. It really is absolutely amazing because it's a free space, it's an artistic space, a thinking space, and businesses are really starting to regentrify. And not in the way that regentrification over here means exclusion of population over here. That's not what's happening. Taking down that wall, and I say it's like a Berlin Wall, for God's sakes. But it was. Artists have made such a difference in that quarter, and I can speak to that from when it wasn't and when it is and what it is now. So, you know, I grew up in Pittsburgh, Washington, D.C., and, you know, Pittsburgh was pretty much my home turf, and I've seen what artists have contributed to the neighborhood and to the economy. So I applaud everybody who's here. And actually, you know, we're old, so we know we know a lot of the artists who have really come to fruition and done so much in that court. The Sprout Fund, for example, if you go up, Assemble, Nina Barbuda. These are all people that are part of my life as an arts educator. So I really applaud you, and I really applaud Wheeling for embracing what Penn Avenue has done. And Michael is one of our World Arts Collaborative artists, and I've been working with him now for, 6 months or so. And I just want to say thank you.